Hello, mortals. I am the booktube goddess, the number one drag queen booktuber on YouTube. And I've looked at bad book covers before, and I wanted to do it again. Last time I did classic bad book covers. This time I found a site called the 16 Most Misleading Book Covers of All Time. So we're in for a treat, I hope. Now every month I pick books based solely on their cover, so it's kind of fun to take a look at these satirical sites. And please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing because I'm trying to grow my channel this year and every person counts. We have 16 most misleading book covers of all time. And we see the first one is Frankenstein. And at first glance, I was thinking, well, he can interpret Frankenstein's monster in different ways, maybe with yellow skin, but he's carrying a sword and he's dressed like a knight, so it's giving me sword and sorcery. And I'm not sure what this is behind him, a mountain, a tree stump, a pastry. I don't know. Misleading, yeah. Next up is Wuthering Heights by Emily Bronte. Okay, Bell and Edwards' favorite book. Oh, what can I say? They do make it look like a Twilight vampire book. Love Never Dies. Well, could fit with Wuthering Heights. If you don't know, Wuthering Heights is about Heathcliff and Catherine. Is that it? Who live on the moors and have a very tragic love story. It's very tragic. Don't think this cover quite fits in, but I can understand the marketing. If it was Bell and Edwards' favorite book, maybe this is a way to get Twilight fans into the classics. Okay. Next up, what? No! The Shining? Okay, I don't know what language this is. Illuminato? Is that Italian? Lotterda. What? Okay, it's a Brazilian edition of Stephen King's The Shining. I have no words! Nothing about this resembles The Shining. It looks like the cover of Vogue or something. A very old cover of Vogue. If someone can explain this one to me, how this relates to The Shining, let me know below. Night and Day by Virginia Woolf. Oh, okay. This is looks like a woman from the 70s or 60s with the big hair and that type of makeup. Certainly not Virginia Woolf, period. Now, I don't know the novel Night and Day. I know Mrs. Dalloway, and I forget what else Virginia Woolf has written, but I don't know this novel, but I bet it's not about a mod girl from the 60s. Okay. 1984 by George Orwell. Okay, this is... Did I see this one before? I can't remember. But it's... Look at that anti-sex woman. Okay, this is definitely the vintage 50s sort of pulp paperback novels trying to get the sex appeal in. Look at the guy in the leather outfit. I mean, it's not misleading. These are images from 1984. The freedom is slavery, ignorance is strength. They have the anti-sex woman, Big Brother, on the poster. It's just creepy. It's just a creepy novel. But there's a lot of these 50s dime store pulp paperbacks that look similar to this. The Scarlet Pimpernel. What? there's a kitten in a briefcase for the Scarlet Pimpernel. You got me. You got me. I don't know how this relates at all. I love the cat, though. I may pick up this book just for the kitty. Great classic series. Large print. Lolita. Out of here. The cove. Is this misleading? I mean, it's about an underage girl who's kind of is exploited, but she's also kind of the exploiter. It's a interesting story. Maybe this doesn't look as misleading as The Briefcase with the Kitten. I'll just say that. Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Okay, I don't really understand the cover, but Hitchhiker's Guide is so weird. I'm not that mad about it. It's just kind of ugly. It just looks like a game of Go with different colored marbles. Trying to think of where they could have gotten this from. Maybe the computer, the supercomputer that tries to answer the question of, or is that? Is that the first book? I don't know. I'm not that mad at this one. It's just ugly. The Giver by Lois Lowry. I don't know if that's that terrible, is it? It looks like he's going in through a time tunnel to get to paradise or to the other side. And The Giver is a post-apocalyptic novel, or young adult. It's a young adult or middle grade. I think it's middle grade. About a boy in a society that's really planned out. So I'm not sure what this is supposed to mean. This time travel type illustration, but... Turn of the Screw by Henry James. No. No. It's an actual turning of the screw. It's the gothic horror novel or thriller of with the turn of the century, and they have an actual wrench turning a screw. Oh my god! Okay. I don't think we can get worse than this. This one got me. This one got me, folks. The Bell Jar by Sylvia Plath. It's a woman putting on makeup. I mean, the novel is about a woman, right? It's about a woman going in an insane asylum, I think. About a woman's mental breakdown. Okay. Well, you tell me. I haven't actually read The Bell Jar, but let me know in the comments if you think this is a misleading cover. Pride and Prejudice. Okay, I think I saw this one from the last cover. It's Lady Godiva riding a horse for Pride and Prejudice. Ooh, Tarzan. I am familiar with Edgar Rice Burroughs. Okay, I understand why they put this in here. It's not that misleading. There's... it's just... a little creepy. Oh boy. Edgar Rice Burroughs. This is a dime store novel. Probably from the 50s or 60s. We're not going to say why they put this here, but... Do androids dream of electric sheep? What? Okay, this is a different language. What? Okay, this is Danish. Philip K. Dick is the science fiction writer from the 60s who was very psychedelic. This is the basis of Blade Runner, the movie. And they just went with electric sheep and wanted to add some sex appeal to it. Okay, this is good. Only the Danes. Anne of Green Gables. Okay, I'm not going to say too much about it, except Anne of Green Gables is known for her red hair, and she lives in the last century on of St. Edward's, or that island in British Columbia. This could be worse. Dorothy and the Wizard of Oz. What? No. Okay, they put a science fiction cover on Dorothy and the Wizard of Oz. Hopefully no Wizard of Oz has nothing to do with space travel. Whoa. Okay, this was quite the collection of misleading book covers. Let me know what you thought was the most misleading. The one that got me the most was Turn of the Screw. But there were a lot of very interesting interpretations. Okay, that's enough for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Until we meet again, may all the books you read be